News about a pregnant teen murdered, her baby cut from her womb, taking over headlines. No matter how shocking it may seem, the horrifying story is not the first of its kind.
Julie Unruh here now with a look back at one story that rocked our area almost 25 years ago. Hi, Julie.
Those of us who've been around may remember this one because Deborah Evans was a mother of three and close to the delivery of her fourth child when she was brutally murdered, her fetus cut from her belly. Sound familiar? Well, the crime is called fetal abduction. History shows it happens, and we've seen it in recent days. The Evans nightmare began in suburban Addison on November 16, 1995.
How could anybody be so low as to do this? I mean, it's just evil.
Sam Evans speaks to WGN-TV from his home about 5 hours outside of Chicago. Evans lost his daughter, Deborah, when these three people shot and killed her inside her Addison home more than 23 years ago. They killed her two oldest children, left Jordan, just 22 months old, to live, and cut Deborah's fourth child from her womb so Jacqueline Annette Williams could claim it as her own. The third suspect, Laverne Ward, helped them pull off the crime. He's the father of both Jordan and the baby, later named Elijah.
I set my life on hold so that I could raise those boys like I raised their mother.
And while Evans was raising his grandchildren, teaching them what it means to live and forgive, the court system repeatedly ripped off the scab and called him back to court for high-profile hearings involving the convicted murderers. But the real pain came rushing back when Governor George Ryan in 2003 cleared out Illinois' death row, acknowledging a broken system. Two of the 167 inmates granted clemency were convicted of killing Deborah Evans.
We were told, okay, you know, they will be in jail without parole, you know, for the rest of their lives. But then, you know, everything changes.
But with time, the Evans family found ways to move forward without hate.
I couldn't continue hating them and holding a grudge because I saw what it was doing to the boys, which meant it was doing that to me.
The National Center for Missing and Exploited Children logged nearly 20 of these rare but unthinkable crimes over the past 30 years. Crude cesareans of at-term babies cut from their pregnant mother's wombs. In 2015, a woman in Colorado posted baby clothes for sale online. She, like allegations in the recent Chicago case, kidnapped the pregnant mother, tried to kill her, and extracted the fetus. The mother in this case survived. The baby did not. In 2017, a man and woman in Fargo, North Dakota, also conspired to kidnap and murder an unsuspecting 22-year-old woman. They killed her after they removed her baby from her womb. That baby survived. While the Chicago area's Deborah Evans did not survive, her son Eli did. Here he is at the age of 16, playing basketball and thriving in his grandfather's care. The year, 2011.
I was taught to forgive people, like, for the bad things that they've done. I always think back to how I survived, like everything that happened, like how I didn't die. I always think that God has like a plan for me since he kept me here.
Families trying to heal, working through the pain the only way they know how.
So I think that's what helped them get through it, was we went through it together and we're still going through it together.
Sam Evans tells me that his grandson, Eli, is now 23 years old, lives nearby, and is doing well. That's about all he really wants to share these days. With time, Eli and his older brother have decided to say less and less about the case that has shaped their lives completely. It appears they're trying to turn the page on this ugly chapter. They'd like to begin writing their own story at this point. They're adult men now. It's a whole different ballgame.
Julie, thanks.
You bet.